With us now is former Republican Congressman Charlie Dent. Congressman, you've called this testimony, at least so far, against President Trump devastating and compelling. If you were still in the House of Representatives as a Republican, would you vote to impeach the president?
Well, Anna, first, I certainly would have voted for the impeachment inquiry. Based on the facts as I understand them now, I do think this rises to the level of impeachment. I would probably support it. That said, I don't think the Democrats should move forward on impeachment until they hear from some of these primary witnesses like John Bolton and Mick Mulvaney and the Secretary of State himself. I think they need to close that loop. I don't think they should force this or rush this. By the same token, neither should the Senate Republicans force or rush a trial.
We haven't even heard Republicans expressing really concern over what came out of the past couple of weeks' hearings. Did you recognize your former Republican colleagues this past couple of weeks?
Well, I think my former colleagues are in a situation where they understand their base pressure. The base is not yet has not yet bolted from the president, and I think that's why they're standing with the president for the moment. But there's no question, having spoken to many of them privately, they are absolutely disgusted and exhausted by the president's behavior. They resent being put in this position all the time. Just take, for example, Anna, when they tried to, remember how they tried to pivot from the Ukraine scandal a few weeks ago by going by pivoting to Doral, you know, bringing the G7 there, moving from one corrupt act to another? I mean, those types of head-exploding moments are just, I think, infuriating these members. And I think they'd like to step out, but they just can't because of their base at the moment.
But where's the courage?
Well, look, I think a lot of members have to take a hard look at this. They can be more concerned about their election or their legacies. And I would argue to many of them, your legacy is more important than the next election. And that's hard for a politician. You're a politician. You want to win. You're competitive. And you do what you must to win. And it's sometimes hard, you know, to try to look at this in a historical context and thinking about, you know, how you're going to be perceived, you know, for years to come. So I think many of them are wrestling with this fact right now, this real challenge. And so there's still time. Give them a little time.
You've said the facts get worse for POTUS daily. The president now putting distance between himself and Rudy Giuliani. What's your read there?
Well, clearly, you know, the president, you know, wants to throw Rudy Giuliani under the bus. That's what I'm seeing here. The fact that he said that, you know, he didn't know what Rudy was doing over there in Ukraine. Well, of course he did. So it's clear that the president, you know, he's you know, loyalty is a one-way street with him. It seems, you know, he expects everyone to be loyalty to him and while he's not loyal to others. I think this president takes the loyalty of so many people for granted and their support. And in fact, at times he mocks their loyalty. And I think that's what's happened here with Rudy Giuliani. But hey, Rudy Giuliani may need to redeem that insurance policy he talked about a few days ago.